At ease, it's your boy Soul Immortal. Today's question comes from a brother named Tassandre. And the brother says, during this COVID-19 mess, I moved in with my girlfriend. We've been dating for about 10 months now. I watched her Virtuous Woman video and she is indeed one. After moving in, I realized I needed to enter in her monk mode and stay on my grind. But it's hard making time for productivity and her as well without burning myself out. I'm going to be here until this pandemic ends. What lesson can I learn from you to stay productive? I feel like I'm Santiago and I've chosen to stay with Fatima in the Oasis. Now, for those that haven't read the book, The Alchemist, when the brother is referring to Santiago and Fatima, this is what he's talking about, right? So The Alchemist is pretty much just a story of the journey of a young man named Santiago. Long story short, he starts off in a place that he really didn't desire. He came to the conclusion that he wanted more out of life and he goes on his journey. He goes through several obstacles and learning experiences, right? So once he gets to the point where he can see his treasure, you know, in the far distance, he's held up by an event and he's at a camp and he meets this young lady. Now this lady is hands down a baddie. This lady is hands down a 5% woman. Long story short, Santiago does some great things in this camp and he gets the bag. Money comes in out of all places, right? Now when it's time to make his move again, he's placed in a position where he can either stay here with Fatima and get married and have a happy life. You know, the money is there, right? Or he can choose to go after his treasure or his purpose, right? Today, brothers, I want to talk to you about your relationship. I want to talk to you about why your relationship is an anchor to your success. Let's talk about it. Now, let me be very clear, disclaimer, because I know the thumbs down are coming. I know the negative comments are coming right behind it. Let me be clear. What I'm not saying is that a man can't succeed at anything if he's in a relationship, right? I'm not saying that. You know, if a brother is trying to get a promotion on his job, if a brother is trying to start, you know, a side hustle to put a few coins in the bank, then he's good, right? But if a brother is trying to break generational curses, if a man is trying to do some things that once seemed impossible to him, you know what I'm saying? If a brother is trying to do something that only a small percentage of the population can do, then odds are his relationship is keeping him from succeeding. Now, why is this? It's solely because a woman has the potential to hinder you from applying the two greatest attributes of success, focus and sacrifice. Now, when I say focused, I'm not talking about going into your office and writing down your goals on a sheet of paper. When I say focus, I'm not even talking about going into your room and meditating and visualizing a thing, right? When I say focus, I'm strictly talking about becoming obsessed with a thing, right? I believe the Bible calls it prayer without ceasing. 1 Thessalonians, maybe chapter 5, if you want to check that out. Now, there are very few preachers that are going to dive into prayer without ceasing. And the reason is the majority of them don't know what that is, right? See, we've been taught that prayer is going into the masjid or going to Juma and prostrating so many times. We've been told that prayer is going into a church and repeating vain repetitions on a weekly basis. But that's not what prayer is. Prayer is simply going into a state. And to pray without ceasing is to go into that state and to never come out. Now, if you want more information on this, you definitely have to check out the recipe. I'll be sure to leave a link in the description box. So why is it so hard for a man that's focused to be in a relationship. It's because it's nearly impossible for a man to remain in this state and to exchange energies with another person. And what I mean by that is, you know, your woman is always going to be cuddling and talking on the phone and Netflix and chilling and going out and doing all this stuff. See, these are all beautiful things. But for a man that's in search of his treasure, for a man that's looking for his purpose, these are vices of destruction. Again, this man has to be obsessed with his goal. Therefore, he must walk alone. Now, the second part of this is sacrifice, right? And it goes without saying that if a man is on his mission, sacrifice must be a part of the program, right? See, the old you wants to pop bottles on the weekends. The old you wants to still go eat at Wolfgang 360 and spend $250 a head. See, the old you still wants to sit on the front row at all the hottest concerts. But now you're understanding that if you want to get to the goal that you have in mind, that it must be sacrifice season, right? See, your woman, she's not going to be able to accept the fact that you've completely removed the word weekend from your vocabulary. In other words, going forward, you're fully aware that your Fridays through Sundays are no longer about, you know, hanging with friends for drinks, or no longer about, hey, let's go to the movies, let's take a trip. Your Fridays through Sundays are now dedicated to your craft. Your Fridays through Sundays are now dedicated to meal preps and getting those extra workouts in. Your Fridays through Sundays are now dedicated to, you know, writing those extra chapters in that book or making that content for your YouTube channel. And I'm telling you, the majority of women, that they aren't going to be able to handle that. And they shouldn't. You know what I'm saying? Again, that's why a man must walk alone. You know, this is the point in a relationship where men are getting frustrated and women are hopping and checking out all the dudes in her DM. So to avoid all of this confusion, to avoid all of this heartache, it's just good for a man on his mission to know that, hey, you know what? This is not my season to be in a relationship. Like, that time will come. So going back to Santiago in the book, The Alchemist, right? The young man had a decision to make. And the thing is, this decision that he had to make is a decision that every man at some point in his life will have to make, right? Because again, Santiago was in a position where he had secured, you know, a fraction of the bag that the universe had in store for him, right? He had met the 5% virtuous thick woman, right? But he had to make a decision. A, does he set his anchor right here and start his life? Does he get married, have the 2.5 kids, the dog, the picket fence, that whole setup, right? Or does he choose the life that continues to travel the road, that continues to go after his dreams, his purpose, his treasure, right? See, I made a video about this just a few weeks ago, talking about that most men aren't built for this. See, this is where the road goes two different ways. Because most men just aren't built to make this kind of decision, right? Now this is the thing that we haven't brought up, right? Like, what about the women in this whole situation? Now I always talk about the 5% and the 95% woman. Now the thing is this: when a man is in this situation and a man says, you know what, you know, I have to go after my purpose, right? This is the way the two women will act. Your 95% women are going to be saying, oh, you know, I knew it. He's this type of guy. You know, he's a narcissist or he's an a-hole. And the reason they think like this is because they're still under the old mindset that man is supposed to sacrifice his life, sacrifice his happiness just to make a woman happy, right? That's the old mindset. But the 5% woman, the 5% woman sees it completely different, and I'll tell you why. See, the 5% woman, she understands the prerequisites of a man being fulfilled, right? She's fully aware that if a man hasn't found self, she's fully aware that if a man hasn't figured out what he wants to give back to the world, she's fully aware that if a man hasn't implemented his services, he can never be in a mental position to properly be in a relationship. So going back to Brother Tassandre's original question, you know, he talked about having the desire to go into monk mode or isolation. Now, this desire is natural, and it's simply because he hasn't fulfilled his purpose yet. And then he talks about, you know, he's unhappy and that after this whole COVID-19 thing is over, he's going his own direction. Now, a man that hasn't found his purpose will always be miserable. You know, at this point, it doesn't even matter if he has a 5%er or a 95%er. At this point, a man will always be miserable if he's chosen to give his love to a woman instead of taking that energy to find his passion. You know, and it goes back to Santiago. You know, I'm not going to tell the story for those that haven't read the book, but Santiago made some tough decisions. And in the long haul, he ended up securing the bag. He ended up finding his purpose, and he found the woman, you know? So in a nutshell, brothers, you know, if you wanna get a promotion from burgers to fries at your job, you know, if you wanna spend 10, 12 years in a place, you know, to get to an assistant manager position or whatever, you know, then you're fine. You're fine with having a good woman in your life, and chances are she can help you get to that point you're trying to get to. But again, if you're trying to make major changes in the world, if you're trying to achieve things that you thought were impossible at some point in time, if you're trying to break generational curses, brothers, then you're going to have to walk that path alone.
At ease!